The Fate of the Furious is the 8th installment to the Fast and Furious film franchise, and centers around Vin Diesel once again playing Dominic Toretto, only now he's turned his back on the one word you never want to make a drinking game out of when you watch any Fast and Furious film.
Family.
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 Family. Family.
Family.
It's
family.
Family.
It's family.
Family. Family.
Yup, his own family. Break out the Coronas and get to drinking. And like any Fast and Furious movie, Fate of the Furious is a non-stop ride of ridiculous over-the-top stunts with a touch of real emotion sprinkled in. But it's the ending of the film that leaves a few questions unanswered, and in case you missed anything, I'll break down exactly how the third act wraps up nicely, like Charlize Theron's weird dreadlocked homage to Angelina Jolie in Gone in 60 Seconds. Comment below who wore it better. Or worse. And before I go any further, keep in mind, everything you hear from here on out has major movie-ruining spoilers to The Fate of the Furious, so you've been warned. So here are the questions from the film's end. How exactly did Dominic and his whole crew unravel Cypher's whole network, releasing Dom from her grasp? Does main protagonist Cypher's plane escape guarantee her a spot as the series' main villain for the next Fast and Furious film? And speaking of the next one, how many more Fast and Furious films can we expect before the series inevitably jumps the shark? No, I don't mean the TV term jump the shark, I mean like one of these days they might literally have a stunt involving jumping out of the jaws of a huge shark. You know, probably. And also, what's the significance of Dom naming his child in the film Brian? I mean, part of me was expecting Maury to make a cameo appearance in this.
You are the father!
I mean, it wouldn't be this bad, but you get it. Anyway, let's get to it. Through most of the second act, it's unknown to anybody why Dom has suddenly decided to turn on his own team. The big reveal comes on Cypher's secret high-tech plane when she reveals that she's kidnapped two people of significant importance to Dom, one of which is Elena, who you probably remember as a member of the police force in Rio, who is recruited by Dwayne Johnson's Hobbs from Fast 5. Then we see her again in Fast and Furious 6, when she becomes Dominic's main love interest when everybody believes that Letty had died. Then briefly again in Furious 7 when Hobbs saves her from an explosion caused by Jason Statham's Deckard Shaw. Man, that baby has been through a lot of action, he's not even one yet. The other person Cypher has, as mentioned, being Dominic's son, which is believed to be the reason why Dom turned, because how do you tell your true love that I thought you died 2 movies ago, so I moved on, you know, relatively quickly, impregnated somebody else, and remember how you talked about how we never talked about having kids? Well, surprise! Anyway, it's these two new members of Dom's family being held hostage that starts the plan to take down Cypher. Cypher's reason for going after Dom being that he screwed up her plans after taking down Moses Jaconde from Furious 7, who had access to the God's Eye technology through Ramsey, and Owen Shaw, Deckard's brother from Fast and Furious 6, who was creating Nightshade, which is basically a glorified EMP device. It's these technologies that Cypher uses to carjack a Russian nuclear sub so she can bomb some random country to create accountability in the world or something. Anyway, it's the second twist where things get a little crazy as Cypher's plan falls apart, revealing the rest of Dom's team behind the scenes. First was Dom's necklace being used as a tracking device. There are many different characters in the Fast and Furious films, from the cast to the cars to even all the copious amounts of butt shots, but another one that's been with us since the beginning is Dom's necklace. Short of stopping a bullet, the necklace has done a lot to keep this crew together all these years, and in this film ends up saving Dom by giving a tracking monitor to the surprise appearance of Helen Mirren in the film, who then uses that information to let her two sons Owen and Deckard Shaw know the whereabouts of Cypher, as well as the faking of Jason Statham's death when Dom shoots him, and then we later see him get pulp fictioned in the ambulance with his waiting mother, Helen. And the two disguised EMTs who were part of Dom's crew in Fast 5, in Leo and Don Omar as Santos. But as for Cypher throwing herself out of her own plane like it was a United Airlines flight, does that guarantee her to be the main protagonist in the Fast and Furious 9, and maybe even further down the line? So first, how many films can we expect? Release dates have been teased online revealing that the saga will wrap up after about 10 films, and these final three will serve as a trilogy building to a decisive conclusion. The problem is, in an interview with the writer of the series, Chris Morgan, he has stated that even though they are aware of the studio's anticipated release dates, there has been no movement as of yet to get an actual story arced out for the final two movies. But Vin Diesel has stated that these final three films are meant to honor the memory of Paul Walker, thus explaining Vin's son in the film being named Brian after Paul's character. And also, fun fact, Vin Diesel's real-life daughter was named Paulina to honor Paul as well. So at this point, it's unclear whether or not Charlize Theron will be the main protagonist for the rest of the series, or if some other hacker-type villain will take the reins. Who knows, maybe there'll be more Game of Thrones alumni to join the cast to be crew or villains. Maybe Dom will change Cypher and make her part of his crew. I mean, after all, it seems like everybody's forgiven Deckard for killing Han, which is still kinda weird when you think about it. Or maybe the saga will end up in Texas on an active NASA launch pad, where the crew will get blasted into space leading to its own spin-off series. Well, whatever ridiculous situation, as soon as I get any word, I'll be sure to let you all know here first. And that's everything I have for the ending explained of The Fate of the Furious. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe below, and tell me your thoughts on the film. Also, be sure to comment whatever ridiculous plot you think will be proposed for these last two films, and what you think their titles will be. Fast and Furious 9 Lives? And maybe Fast and Furious Fast 10 Your Seatbelts? Yeah, that one was terrible. And don't forget, as always, this is Five Fingers Explains Everything with the Fingabang Show. I'm out.